Welcome back to our channel. It's a bee here, and today I'm so excited because today we are going to be making Sultani Kabsa in the Pakistani style. So let's get started.
Okay, today we're gonna make Sultani Kabsa. Kabsa is a Saudi dish. Basically, it's made in Arab countries, Yemen, Saudi Arabia, and all those other Middle Eastern countries. So what you need is basically it's a rice with meat. You can either use chicken or goat meat or beef as well. So for that, you need 3 cups of sela rice. Now sela are a little bit longer rice than regular basmati rice, so I use the golden classic sela. It's pretty good. Even says, you know, extremely long grain basmati rice. And then you need 2 kilos of meat. This is goat meat and mixed with beef meat. And for the spices, all I use is this Shan's mandi or kabsa. It says mandi or kabsa spices, which is pretty good. So I don't have to put anything. All I do is use the whole pouch and put it in there. You need 2 tomatoes, cut tomatoes, a little bit of green chilies, 2 to 3 tablespoons of tomato paste, a little bit of garlic and paste, garlic and ginger paste. That's optional if you want. 1 onion, you need that. This is to make sauce with it. So what we're gonna do is that these things are used to only to make the sauce to put on top of kabsa. It tastes really good. You need 3/4 cup of vegetable oil as well. We're gonna cook first meat in pressure cooker, and then we're gonna make broth, and then we will transfer in this pot and we'll cook it in this one. So once meat is tender, I will transfer the broth in this pot and I will cook the rest of the meat with the spicy a little bit more in the pressure cooker, and we will serve it in this whole tray. For these spices, you can get it in Edmonton from Desi Bazaar, which is 34th Avenue and I believe between 91st and 95th Street somewhere. You can get this from there as well, and you can get the meat. This is a halal meat as well, of course. Here, let's get started. So this is the pot we're gonna use to cook kabsa, and we're gonna make kabsa in the oven. Basically, it will be cooked in the heat and it will taste amazing. So what we will do, once everything's ready, we will transfer everything in this pot, we'll cover it, and then we will throw it in the oven on 255 degrees for 1 hour. And that's how kabsa is prepared, okay? So now first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna add oil to the pressure cooker. A lot of people say, including myself and my family, say that, you know, there's some kind of smell in meat. So what we do is that we heat up the oil, and the trick is that you add the meat in the pot and cook it for 5-10 minutes. So basically what's gonna happen is that once the color is turned white, that means all the smell and everything is gone. So we're gonna cook this for next 5 minutes till it turns white, and then we will add onions to it. So now we've been cooking this meat for 2 minutes, and you can see that the color is turning white. You can see that it's white. So basically what's happening is that we're getting rid of the smell from the meat. And that's the trick, as I mentioned earlier, in the oil, you just add a meat and you cook it for 2 to 5 minutes till the color is turned white, which is doing it right now. So we've been cooking basically meat for 5 minutes, and look at that, the color is white now. So we know it got rid of all the smell, if there is any. And now we're gonna add onions to it. That's one whole chopped onion. And we will cook this for probably 2-3 minutes. And we will add, for 3 cups of water, we will add 3.5 cups of water, and we're gonna put it on pressure and pressure cooker for 15 to 20 minutes. So what it will do, the meat will be tender, and after that we will have broth of almost 5 cups. So now we will add 3.5 cups of water in this, and we will put it on. As I mentioned earlier, you need 5 cups total. So put 3.5 and put in pressure for 15-20 minutes. At the end, the broth will be 5 cups. So now we will just cover it and pressure it for. So the pressure is done for 20 minutes and here we go. So now we have broth and the meat is pretty tender. So what we will do, we will take that whole broth and transfer it to this pot. Okay, since we transferred the broth to the other pot, so we're gonna add in this one all the spices. So I added one whole packet of this Shan masala mandi. We're gonna add 2-3 tablespoons of tomato ketchup. Tomato ketchup. We will add 2 cut tomatoes and a little bit of green chili and probably 2-3 tablespoons of garlic and ginger paste. Now we'll add food. So we will cook this for probably 4 to 5 minutes and it should be good. Then we will add this whole thing to the broth as well, and then we will add rice to the pot and we will throw it in the oven on 255 degrees for 1 hour. I already set the oven to 255. We will cook on 255 degrees for 1 hour. It should be good. Okay, so now we cook meat for 10 minutes almost and it's ready. So we're gonna add this meat to the broth. That's it. Bora? Okay, so now we added the broth, meat to the broth, and once it's gonna boil, as soon as it starts boiling, we will add rice to it. We will add the rice, we will cover it, and then we will throw it in the oven on 255 degrees for 1 hour exactly. So since now it's boiling, we will add 3 cups of cellar rice to the pot. And once it starts boiling, we will add that to, we will cover it and we will throw it in the oven for 1 hour on 255 degrees. So now we have rice in there and it's boiling the broth, so now it's time, that's a sign that you should cover it and throw it in the oven, toss it in the oven for on 255 degrees for 1 hour and that's it. Okay, so now we're gonna make sauce for the kabsa. So we toss in there 2 cut tomatoes, 1 green chili, a little bit of garlic, and then we're gonna add a little bit of salt in it. And then a little bit of lemon juice. That's for the taste, that's good. Now we're gonna grind it. ready. So now I'm just gonna taste if it's okay. That is good. Thank you. We're gonna. Okay, so it's been 1 hour, so this should be ready. So we're gonna take it off and we're gonna check it out. Oh my god, this is perfect. So this is perfect, and we're gonna mix it. So you can just tell by the smoothness that. So I'm just, the reason why I'm doing this is I'm just mixing all the spices in there, because once it's cooked, all the spices are on top. You want to make sure they're all mixed and mixed. So once it's done, I'm just gonna shift it from here to this. There you go. It's ready, guys. So let's eat.